So this comeback, how long is it going to last, you think?
Yeah, thanks for having me, Martin. Good morning. Well, you know, it could be short-lived because after the bell, yeah, you guys mentioned the earnings of Google and Amazon, both of which underwhelmed, although there were some positives mixed in. And so, you know, tech was a big driver in today's rally. And indications are that maybe the outlooks there aren't as great as maybe investors would hope. And that could extend. In fact, a lot of names were down after hours in sympathy there. And so it's going to be a very interesting day tomorrow to see if the market can hold or add to those gains or whether we have another round of selling. I for one, think that the volatility is not over. I think while corporate earnings are good, it's been expected. Investors are expecting good outlooks. If they don't get them, that's going to be a problem. And when you compare that to the potential harder comparisons for earnings going forward, the uncertainties relating to trade, the Fed, geopolitical issues, et cetera, and global economic growth, it makes for a mixed picture right now.
And what do you think investors should be doing?
Well, we would advocate diversification, which we're well known for anyway in our permanent portfolio. So I think unless you have strong conviction in any one direction, and if you do, by all means, follow it. But for most investors, I think they're torn a little bit in which direction they ought to go. And so we would advocate not getting out of stocks completely, looking for values, looking for areas that have been overly beaten down with good growth prospects, financials, materials, you know, manufacturing, I think, are all good areas, biotech and some tech as well. We would also advocate on the bond side, low duration, high quality, so shorter term and investment-grade bonds to take advantage of rising rates, but also protect the balance sheet. And in periods of uncertainty and potential inflationary pressures, we would advocate holdings of precious metals like gold and silver as well to supplement a portfolio.
Still watching? Perfect. Click here to watch another great video from CNBC International. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.